You may have noticed that most cameras provide different video formats to choose from. People often ask what the difference is between H.264 or H.265 and JPEG video, and why should I change from one to another? Let's start by examining frame rates. Frame rates are expressed as FPS, or frames per second. Video is made up of sequences of still frames. When the frames are sped up fast enough, our brains perceive it as motion. More frames per second also equals smoother perception of motion. However, many users do not require recording at very high frame rates, so lowering the frame rate recorded will benefit their network bandwidth. Additionally, fewer frames to record means less space is consumed on the hard drive, meaning that video retention time can be increased without adding storage capacity. This is a balancing act dependent on what level of capture is necessary. A motion JPEG stream, often just shortened to JPEG when discussing only video, is a compression format that individually compresses each frame of video. You may be familiar with JPEG since it is a popular still image format that has been around for a long time. When utilizing this for video, the stream is a series of these JPEG compressed images. In the pictured example, the clouds and sky have not changed between frames, yet you must retransmit the data for those pixels with every frame. In contrast, an H.264 video stream is made up of I-frames, short for intra-frames, and P-frames, short for predicted frames. The I-frames consist of a full frame of data and are sent at regular intervals. However, in between these I-frames are P-frames, which, rather than sending an entire frame of data, consist only of the pixels that have changed. This presents a savings in terms of the amount of data being sent because pixels which haven't changed don't need to be retransmitted. Every P frame refers to the data that came before it. In some uses, the stream could also include B frames, B for bidirectional frames. It's not too important to understand the details of how B frames work, but when used, B frames fit between I and P frames, or multiple P frames. Software examines the frames before and after it and try to extrapolate a frame in between the two. The reason B frames are not always used is because it introduces latency. The software must sample a frame that hasn't occurred yet. Therefore, there is a buffer in which the frames queue until both the preceding and the next frame can be examined and the B frame can be calculated before it is actually displayed. We will focus on I frames and P frames for our uses. H.265 is the next iteration of this technology and simply improves the efficiency of compression by dividing frames into dynamically sized blocks rather than same size blocks to accommodate underlying data differently. In many cases, H.265 provides additional savings in file sizes and bandwidth consumption. Returning to our concept of I-frames and P-frames for a moment, the interval between each full I-frame is referred to as a GOP length, short for group of pictures. Some camera brands may also refer to this as the GOV length, or group of video images. Lengthening this interval decreases file size and bandwidth consumption, but can lead to something called a heartbeat effect, in which the video appears to pulse. This is caused by the pixels in the I frame, which did not get updated in the P frame, becoming old, and so when the new full I frame arrives, there is a larger difference in the refreshed image. Resolve this heartbeat effect by logging into the camera's web interface and lowering the GOP length, so that the full I-frames appear more often.